Hey there again, TikTakers! Today, we'll be exploring more curious facts about the human body. More specifically, we'll be talking about a condition related to how our eyes detect colors and how our brains perceive them. A condition known as color blindness. Are you familiar with it? Color blindness is the inability to see colors in a normal way. Most people who suffer from this condition struggle differentiating reds and greens and frequently also blues. Because of this, this condition is also known as color vision deficiency. This is a genetic disorder, and men are much more likely to suffer from it than women. It is believed that about 1 in 10 men suffer from some kind of color blindness. Interesting, right? And now you might be wondering, why is it that some eyes don't perceive colors correctly? Well, we'll try to explain it in a simple way. The retina, which is located in our eyes, has two kinds of cells which detect light, the cones and the rods. The rods detect light and darkness, while the cones detect colors. In a very summarized and simplified way, there are three types of cones. The ones that detect reds, the ones that detect greens, and the ones that detect blues. Our brain uses the information sent by the cones to determine the colors we perceive. However, there will be issues if one or more of the cones are missing, or if they're not working properly, or if they're detecting different colors than normal. The most severe type of color blindness occurs when all the three types of cones are missing, and the most mild occurs when the three types are present, but one of them is not working correctly. And depending on how they are working or if they are missing is how we can determine different kinds of color blindness. The most severe kind of color blindness, known as achromatopsia, results in the patient only being able to distinguish a scale of grays. In other words, they can only detect white, black, and gray. However, this is the least frequent kind of color blindness in the world. The next kind of color blindness in terms of severity is called monochromatism, which occurs when only one of the three kinds of cones works correctly, and so the patient can only detect one kind of color. Then we have dichromatism, which occurs when the patient only has two working cones and results in the person having difficulties distinguishing reds from greens or blues from yellows. And lastly, we have anomalous trichromatism, where the patient has all three cones but some or all of them don't work correctly. This is the most common type of color blindness, and its practical consequences are similar to dichromatism. So, as you can see, TikTakers, there are many different ways in which we can perceive colors. And for people who don't suffer from color blindness, it's hard to imagine what life would be like without some of the colors we can detect without issues. So, we invite you to imagine what your daily life would be like if you were colorblind. For instance, let's say you're driving through the city in your car and a traffic light is showing the red light. In that case, everyone who is not colorblind will immediately stop their car because they understand the signal. However, if you were colorblind, you would need to learn beforehand what the traffic lights mean at each particular position. Now imagine that you're in the middle of a class and the teacher starts explaining something using a graph or a map. If they are divided by colors and you were colorblind, that could be very confusing for you. So now you know, TikTakers. If you know of someone close to you who suffers from color blindness, be helpful with them and use other ways to represent things besides color whenever possible. Color blindness is hereditary, but other disorders exist which can produce similar effects, such as Parkinson's, glaucoma, Alzheimer's, and cataracts. Also, color blindness can be diagnosed by showing the patient special drawings composed of multicolored dots. As of the year 2021, color blindness has no cure, TikTakers. However, several studies are being carried out which have shown good results in animals, but they're not applicable to humans yet. Either way, most people afflicted by this condition use different methods to substitute colors in their day-to-day lives. And in different parts of the world, special contact lenses and glasses have been developed which can be helpful to them. Do any of you suffer from color blindness? If you do, let us know in the comments how you deal with it. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like it. And if you want to see more Draw My Life videos, subscribe to our channel. See you in the next episode!